Sara is enjoying a peaceful moment with her book when suddenly her phone rings. It's a call from her office with an urgent task. She needs to update the inventory operations. A link is sent and she quickly opens it on her phone. Sara tries to do the work on her phone, but it is too hard to navigate in the mobile phone browser. The icons are too small and navigating the site is difficult. She is getting frustrated, unable to complete the task. But what if there was a better way? Hi, I am Nishtha. Meet Odoo Native Mobile App, Mobile Client, the perfect solution for managing your business on the go, with features designed to boost productivity. Deliver a seamless user experience and integrate with hardwares like printers and scanner, enabling quick tasks like printing receipts and scanning inventory. With its enhanced performance and user-friendly design, managing your operations is simple and fast without any lag. Plus, real-time sync ensures instant update across the devices, and there is no need for scratch development. The app is ready to go out of the box. Now let's check the workflow. But before that, make sure to subscribe to our channel and tap the notification bell to stay updated with the latest content. Apart from this, I would like to mention that if you need extensions for increasing the sales of your e-commerce store, then you can visit store.webcool.com and explore a number of products for every technology. We also have the user guide for the same in our blog sections, from where you can check the features and configuration and get to know the functionality of the extensions as well. Now let's move back to our video. Now let's check our app from our web browser and the mobile client as well. Here you can see I'm having an iOS device in my hand. Once you install the app, it will reflect like this on your home page. We'll tap on the app to open the app. Tap on the app like this. Here you can see the home menu icons are there. You can check any of the menus by just tapping on the app and can manage the same. Now, first of all, we'll check if we are going to install the app from our web browser, will it going to reflect to our mobile client as well? So navigating towards our web browser, click on home menu from there and choose the apps. Here you can check the list of the apps is visible. Now, for example, I want to add this app. So we'll click on activate. Once the app is added, you can check the same in the list of the home menu. You can see it is there. Now let's check it in our mobile client. Here we have to refresh it. After refreshing, we can check the same app which we have installed from our web browser in our mobile client as well. And you can open the app and can manage the same. Now let's create a product from our mobile client and again we'll check the same on our web browser. So we'll navigate towards the website and choose the e-commerce, choose products from there, create a product, write down the name for your product, choose the image if you want. Click on is published and then save it. Record saved successfully. That means the product is created. Now we can check the product from our web browser. So now navigating towards the home menu and click on sales from there. Choose the products. Again products. Here write down the name of the product which we have created. And there you can see the product is reflecting. If you want to check the same product on your website, so for that you can navigate towards the website. Go to shop. Search the product. The product is there, which we have created from our mobile client is reflecting at our web browser and the website as well. Now let's create an order from our mobile client. Tap on sales, orders, again orders, create. Now you have to choose the customer from there. Add the product from the order lines. Click on product variant. Choose the product variant, then product. Here you have to write down the product description. Add the unit price from there. Choose the taxes. Now moving back, click on save. Record saved successfully. That means the order is created. Now we have to check this order from our web browser. So navigating towards the home menu and then click on sales. Here we have the option of orders. Choose the quotations. There you can see the order which we have created from our mobile client is reflecting at our web browser end. If you change the status of this order, it will reflect the same on our mobile client and the web browser. For example, if I'll change it to confirm, you can see the status is changed to sales order. If we'll choose this there also, you can see the status is changed to sales order. Now let's check if you are having two different users, how you can manage it. Right now we are logged in with the admin access. That's why we can see all the home menus options and can manage the same from our mobile client. If in case we have created a new user, so how will it will going to reflect to our mobile client? Let's check it out. First of all, we'll navigate towards the home menu in our web browser and click on settings. Here choose users. There you can see the list of users which we have already created is visible. For example, I have created this user recently. You have given the access to this. So the access which you have given, only those menus will going to reflect to this particular user on your mobile client also. So let's going to log in. Logging out from our mobile client as an admin. Now entering the username and the password of our new user. Write down the password from there and click on login. There you can see the home menu list is shorted. That means the access which we have given to this particular user, only those home menus the user can check and can manage it. So this is how you can also manage your business operations from your mobile client. Empower your team with the Odoo Native Mobile App. Experience the freedom of working anytime, anywhere. Download now and transform the way you manage your business. Odoo Native Mobile App, empowering your business anytime, anywhere. Found this video insightful? Do press the like button and share your views in the comment section below. If you have any questions or need assistance, feel free to contact us at support@webcool.com or visit it at webcool.uvdesk.com. See you all in the next one. Till then, thanks for watching. Stay tuned.